Alright guys, we're here again at Predatory Pins. Never ends. Can't wait for 2019. I'm tired of construction and putting things together. But this is the new pond that we got for the alligator gars. It's gonna be a round tank with four viewing panels. A lot smaller than the mega tank, but it would still be pretty nice. A nice navy blue color. Platinum gar will look really cool in here. There's more construction, more plumbing, more filtration. It never ends. We're actually helping a friend of ours move a big tank. We have to get all the equipment necessary and build some dollies. These little babies right here will be able to move the 800 gallon tank. I mean, 700 gallon tank. All the last 10 feet wide. 10 feet long, 3 feet wide, 3 feet tall. It's pretty heavy. We got a couple more to build just in case we gotta move any big tanks. These things are also perfect. Meanwhile, we still gotta get more shipments in. The shop is looking pretty empty right now. We've been pretty busy just building stuff, so I didn't wanna, you know, take the risk of hoarding any fish and have them just die and not taking care of them. But I should be getting more orders for this month. I just really got to get this done because this is taking a lot of our time and space. Every time the shop is clean, we do something else. You know, these guys here need a bigger home. So they're all going to go in there. Plus, anytime we have a big fish that gets caught or donated, they can't go in there because they end up eating the smaller fish. They'll go in here with the gars. And then this tank right here will be a quarantine tank for any fish that come from overseas. They're large, too big to go in a tank. They'll go in there first to get quarantined. But a lot of people are going to ask me, like, what do we do for our fish to be so healthy? And mainly this is the reason right here. This water treatment, perfectly clear water from West Palm Beach helped us hook it all up. But mainly there's two carbon filters, and the water goes through both of them, and it goes through a pipe in the back. And that, what that does is that removes the chloramine and chlorine out of the water, so we still have the ammonia. And these two filters right here remove the ammonia, and the water will go under on top of those big tanks back there. And that's what we use our water to fill up them. All the tanks in the shop, the water changes. Both went together, 1,200 gallons. So we do, you know, once a month, we'll change the water on all those tanks. And like the week after, we'll do a water change here and out this tank as well. The good thing about this tank is there's so much filtration that it doesn't really need that much of a water change. Fluorized bag filter, that right there will take care of a lot of the ammonia, and we'll keep the water pretty clear and nice. Let's see if I can get in there. I mean, the lights are off, and you can still see all the way here. Yeah, Obama gets out of the way, you can still see all the way across, you know, 10 foot. This is 10 feet long tank. But the fish are looking pretty healthy. They're eating very well. Very active at night. You know, a lot of them are nocturnal fish. But that's it. There's not really much more to do here. Just gotta keep changing the filter tags. Gotta make sure the light's not on. Oh, all right, we still have to do these guys. What I wanna do is I wanna cut them to the size of the metal bars and zip tie the ends, so in case of arapaima or arowana, you know, hit the top of it, it won't go anywhere. But it still needs a lot to do. And here, basically, this is all. It's gonna be loud in there, but it's just all the work we gotta do is keep changing this filter. So this one's already clogged. That's literally clear pine on the water. Like all that gunk was in there and it wasn't letting go.
that was the reason why I couldn't see through the water, you know? So every day, at least, yeah, once a day, we'll come here and we'll wash all this sand. I think this is pretty much what it is, the sand and algae bloom. Get all this out. This is just a couple of days. So you get to see how much waste.
You know,
plus, you know, it's a new tank, so there's a lot of like sand moving around in the water, getting caught in there.
Still gonna add more rock on that side. There's plenty of space here to add more.
See, when you're dealing with a big tank like this, you want a long sump or tank that you can have the water run through all your media. You know, the longer it runs, the more it gets filtrated. But the water now, it's looking pretty clear. And this is just a couple days. It's been running full speed. Doesn't smell bad at all. Like, you know, like when you get into a dirty tank, it smells pretty good in here. Rich tank.
Feed them pretty well.
Every other day. Mine's that green, giant green around me. Doing pretty good now.
And that little fish still right.
All those fish are getting along, that's pretty good. And then what I did also, I did a video on it, but I plumbed this tank here into the same sump. And I have a pump shooting back. This one's shooting back. So this water, the air waters, we've got a big armada that's here. There it is. It's a grow out tank for the mega farm. Getting pretty tired of building stuff. I'm not an expert, I just learn as I go, but it's a lot of work. And every time you come here and this is all clean, and the next day it's a mess again. This is all the stuff we got that comes with the pond. Right? Sure. Resin, this is filler for the space. Put the two pieces together, whatever space is left. You gotta fill it with that. I don't know what this is. Oh, I guess a hardener. Then you get all the bolts and nuts to put it together. So basically, the weight, it's pretty crazy the way this holds onto it. So we gotta make holes here, all the way down, with this. Attached to that one, put nuts and bolts. I mean, that's on both sides to hold it tight on that side and this side. And then the bottom, what we're gonna do is we're actually gonna drill to the concrete. So we won't need a metal bracket on top because it's a round tank, and the bottom of it will be attached to the concrete so it won't open up. Now, you know, you'll see. Decent amount of money by not having to put metal brackets like those guys. That you definitely need it because it was an oval tank, so it could blow out any minute. But these are pretty strong in there, and they're pretty tight, so it's definitely not going anywhere. I mean, it's been up and running for what, a month now, and not 1 week, thank God. Yeah, so this tank is pretty much done. Now it's time to focus on this one. It's gonna be a nice tank, and what we want to do is paint the outside black.
see if I can find some chrome spikes to put in here to look pretty cool, like the predatory tank. But after that, I'm done. 100%, I'm not adding any more tanks here. I'm not doing anything else. I might move this freezer out of here and put another tank here, and that's it. That's it. I promise, this is it. There's plenty of tanks here to put fish. I still gotta work on the filtration for that tank. This is everything that we're gonna use, but that's for another day. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Like I said before in the prior videos, we're gonna try to be posting more often. Pretty much three times a week if we can. We're trying to hire a company to help us with the YouTube videos because I don't have all the time in the world to be making videos. Hopefully we'll get that done soon and be able to post enough videos for you guys. But if you have any questions, you know, we're trying to build a pool pond. I have questions on filtration, you know, what fish to get with each other, and put it in there. Let us know, you know, in the comments below. We'll be more than happy to help. A lot of times I don't have the time to answer everybody back, but I promise if I see you, I'll definitely answer and help as much as I can. All right, thanks for watching, subscribe. I'll see you next video.